Hi, I'm Spencer Brinkerhoff III. To supplement the Art of Resistance Teacher Toolkit, I've been asked to introduce the basics of story and character development and design. The story and the world that the story takes place in is the foundation to the design process. As an example, let's consider the city of San Francisco from the movie Big Hero 6. That story takes place in an alternate future where after the 1906 earthquake, San Francisco was rebuilt by Japanese immigrants. When it was completed, it was renamed San Francisco due to it being a city with Japanese and American architecture merged. Through these combined cultures, we have an advancement in science and technology, and that's where the brightest students attend the San Francisco Institute of Technology, and that's where we meet the characters for our story. The history and the environment of this world have helped to shape the characters of the story, as well as the challenges that they face. At the core of Big Hero 6, we can see that the advancement of technology in the world has led to a dangerous experiment and a test pilot has been lost. Now, this experiment drives the pilot's father to seek revenge and the heroes use their advanced technology to stop him. These elements of the world have helped to shape the story. When building your own world, you must answer these questions. Does the story take place in the past, in the present, or in the future? Is it our world, or is it a fictional world? And what are the rules in this world, and what are the consequences for breaking those rules? How does the characteristics of this world add conflict to your story? With the world established, we can start to look at the characters that live in it and develop their stories as well. Author and researcher Joseph Campbell studied myths and hero stories from around the world. He found that there was a common pattern to almost all of these stories. His book, The Hero with a Thousand Faces, further establishes this pattern and provides us with an outline to create our own stories. The heroes of these stories are usually reluctant participants in epic adventures. They live in their ordinary but broken world. They wish that things were different, but they feel powerless to make a change. And this is where the myth pattern begins. The hero of the story is called to adventure. They accept the challenge and find a mentor to lead them on their adventure. They face their trials and conquer their fears. Then they claim the treasure they seek and return to heal their broken world. Think of Luke Skywalker, Harry Potter, and Katniss Everdeen, and see the pattern of the hero's journey. Each one of them received a call to leave their ordinary world. They accepted the challenge and found a mentor. They overcame their trials and returned to their world with the ability to make it better. These are the basics of world building and storytelling that provide a structure for us to design the characters, the tools, and challenges. Now that we know our world and we have an outline for our hero's journey, the design and the characteristics of that hero become a natural extension of the world they live in. So we're just sitting, you know, are we recording now? And then we kind of do like some of this stuff. That's a fake smile. Another fake smile. You caught me too on it. My lips are sticking to my teeth. That provide a structure for us to... Oh, I was so on. Provides us with an online. I flubbed like three times. I was like, blah, blah.
That was good.
Yeah, shimmy.
A little shimmy there.